Join Bob Ward and myself to get a bunch of tips and tricks about migrating to Azure SQL this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Bob Ward. Bob, thanks so much for coming on the show again. It's great to have you.
Yeah, here we are in 2022, Anna, my first Data Exposed episode of the year. Great to be back with you again.
Awesome. It's great to have you. I know folks are really enjoying the SQL Server 2022 series that you kicked off last year. And, you know, you've been working a lot on SQL Server 2022. I wanted to have you on the show to kind of find out, because I know you're always working on a ton of things. What else is going on in your world?
Yeah, thanks for asking, Anna. Like late last year, not just SQL Server 2022, but it came to my attention that maybe I could spend some more time teaching customers that were on older versions of SQL Server how to migrate to Azure, make it very SQL Server focused. So I kind of built something called the Migrate SQL Server to Azure Workshop and delivered it, actually an in-person event, if you can believe that. Did it virtually at the PaaS Summit and then did it in person at the MS SQL Conf in Las Vegas. So it's been a lot of fun kind of putting it together, taking my knowledge of SQL Server and translating that to how customers can move to Azure. And so you see here on the slide, Anna, I've got a slide here that shows here a couple links. One of them is a link, the very first one is to a GitHub site based on our famous SQL workshops, where we give you, it's kind of in preview right now, it's just kind of starting, and you can keep track of it as we update it, but it has the full slide deck of what we use to present the workshop. And it has examples of going through various aspects to migrate. So the second link is data migration. And we'll talk about that, and I think maybe at the very end of our discussion today. But what I thought I might do, if it's okay with you, is just kind of give folks a sneak peek of what this workshop looks like.
Yeah, I think that would be great. So you've been working on this workshop. You've delivered it a couple times. You are planning to deliver it. Maybe you could also share with us, you're planning to deliver it in person a couple more times at some upcoming events.
Yeah, can you believe that? Delivering it in person, a couple of events. I have to like say that twice to myself to believe it. But yes, you may have heard of a very famous conference called SQL Bits in March. I'll be traveling across the pond to go over and deliver a full training day with this exact workshop. And then in April, the MS SQL Conf, the SQL Server and Azure SQL Conference is coming back again to Vegas in April. And I plan to deliver it in person there as well.
Awesome, cool. So UK or US or Europe, you might consider attending this in person. But in the meantime, Bob, yeah, I think it would be great to have a sneak peek. What are some of the things you're going to cover and what are people going to learn?
Well, you know, Anna, when I was thinking about doing this workshop, I thought to myself, based on my years of SQL Server experience, you know, how would I approach this if I had SQL servers? And as it turns out, we have modules like any kind of workshop would. So I first kind of built this slide to show an organization of when you do the workshop, what modules flow through what I call migration scenarios. And so module one is actually teaching people about Azure. If you don't know anything about Azure, we just kind of teach you the fundamentals of Azure. Module two is about discovering and assessing your SQL servers. So we have something called Azure Migrate, and we specifically have a functionality, it's in preview with VMware, where you can discover thousands of SQL servers across your VMware enterprise, and then you can assess what those look like. But let's say that you kind of figured out a couple of SQL servers you want to focus on migrating. So what we do also in module two is we take two scenarios. One is a SQL Server 16 instance and a SQL 19 instance. And we use the data migration assistant to assess specifically looking at compatibility issues or perhaps even looking at your workload and deciding based on the performance of my workload, which way should I go? Like, should I go to Azure Virtual Machine? Should I go to Managed Instance? What specific choices should I make when I go to those? How big is my VM? How big should managed instance? How many cores do I need? And Anna, you know, and I've worked with you in Azure before, those are tough choices you have to make. So the Migration Assistant tool can look at your workload and give you some of those recommendations. And we walk through what that looks like. Now, what we also do is we'll take a look at SQL 16 and we'll come up with possible requirements for your migration that will lead you down the path of migrating to Azure Virtual Machine. And one of those could be that you have like an ISV application that requires SQL Server 16. So even though DB Compat exists, you have to use that certain version of SQL. So therefore, Virtual Machine's a great option for you. And we talk about how to do like an assessment of that, look at your requirements, build a plan, and then do an offline migration during that situation based on your requirements. Now for the SQL 19 instance, let's say, for example, your ISV app says it's okay that you go to a versionless platform as a service. So, oh, I'm sorry. One of the things that I forgot to tell you about is that we have this kind of idea of a life cycle here. So when we're discovering, assessing, and we start going into migrations, we're not just going to show you how to migrate, but when you're done, we're going to show you how to optimize and manage that migration. You know, how do you make it the best once you get to that destination, right? We'll show you a quick example of that as well. So on the SQL 19 side, though, what we'll do is we'll assume that maybe platform as a service is okay for you. Managed instance could be one of those targets. So we'll show you how to do an online migration, and we'll focus on using a new extension. I think you've had these folks on your show using Azure Data Studio to do that migration. So that's pretty cool. And then we'll also show you how to optimize and manage that. So if you think about these scenarios, you got a SQL 16. That could be a common situation for customers, right? SQL 16, you got to stay there. So VM's a great way to get to the cloud. But for SQL 19, maybe an online migration to managed instance, you know, would be a good choice. And then I was building this workshop. I thought to myself, now, if you're in virtual machine, but you want to go to managed instance because maybe your ISV app allows you to do that, how do you do that? So the final module is to show you exactly that. Like if I got into the cloud already, could I make that shift over to managed instance? And we'll talk about that using Azure Data Studio and Log Replay Service. So Anna, if you just look at this, it's a pretty cool idea, right? Because the concept is it's a very common situation and scenario for customers today and how to go leverage all the tools we've built to do the migration.
Awesome. And one quick question here. These numbers, what are these numbers?
Yeah, I know. It was hard to like not put a little table or legend in here, but the numbers represent the module numbers.
Oh.
So module one is just about introducing you to Azure. Like we'll just talk about Azure so just so you can get those fundamentals down. Module two is in this lifecycle thought. How do you discover and assess your current SQL servers? Module three is how to migrate to VM, Azure VM. Module four is to optimize and manage that migration to VM. And then five is to take SQL 19 and how to migrate to managed instance. And then six would be optimizing, manage that migration to managed instance. And then seven is to put it all together by saying, if I'm in VM already, how do I go over to managed instance? So the end result would be when you're done with the whole workshop, you've got everything in managed instance.
Oh, awesome. So if I go through the workshop or if I look at the materials, I'm going to learn all of these things.
I know. Awesome. You know, you've known me for a long time. You know, I'm never shy of putting a lot of information into something. So the folks that did this session in person when I did this right in Vegas, they were just like drained by the end of the day because it was a lot of information. But every one of them said, I really feel more comfortable now going forward to make these decisions, you know, to do a migration.
I love it. So Bob, can you give us a couple highlights of things that are going to be included in this workshop or things folks might want to know about migrating?
Sure. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to show you how to use this Azure Migrate tool, right? It's a one-stop shop in Azure where you do what's called, you download what's called an appliance. It's like a piece of software that you put in your VMware environment. We wanted to show you a little bit of what that looks like because you may have a scenario where you have a lot of SQL servers and you kind of need an inventory of what they all look like. And you need recommendations from Microsoft about where to go. Should I go to VM? Should I go to managed instance? What choices should I make in between there? So we're going to show you that one-stop experience using Azure Migrate. But what we're also going to do is help you move from there. Let's say you've made some decisions on, like I showed you in that scenario, you made some decisions that you may want to go to like Azure VM. So when you do that, we're going to show you and demonstrate an offline migration. Now, you can do an online migration too, and we talk about it, but we're going to focus on a simulation as though an offline is the easiest, best way for you. And so we show you some choices, and I'll show you to visually here. Now, you're going to laugh at this one. Do you know that if you've got Azure Virtual Machine and you're going to move a SQL server in there, and it's offline, so it's just a backup restore type concept, if you have a very small database, you can just like copy the file into the VM. I just all the time, like do like a copy and paste into an RDP session and then just restore the database. So if it's just like a 30 megabyte database, why go through a big contrived process? Just copy the file over and restore it. But let's say it's larger, it's a little more complex process. This is where you can do something like this. And this is a tried and true process that people have done actually for a while. And that is SQL Server supports backing up to Azure Blob Storage. So we show you how to back up your existing SQL Server on premises to Azure Blob Storage. Then you turn around in the virtual machine itself and you just restore from the blob storage and you're up and running. So it's a very simple process, but we walk you through the steps to actually go do that. And we actually use Management Studio because it's a great wizard-like experience to do it. But we show you how to deploy your virtual machine using called the Marketplace and then do your restore. And then finally, we do talk about the option of using Azure Data Studio with its new migration extension, where you would use something called a self-hosted runtime piece of software in your on-premises environment. You are going to back up your database, not to Azure Blob Storage now, but to a local folder, which is shared. Azure Data Studio uses the database migration service to copy that backup and to restore it and recover it into VM. So we focus on number two as a demo to show you this, right, as an example, but we give you the different options that are possible to you. The one thing also that we do mention, Anna, that you and I have talked about before is a lot of people may not be aware of this, but let's say you just want to take the entire VM and just move the whole thing into Azure. Azure Migrate comes with an option to lift and shift like a snapshot of the VHD and just put it in Azure. And then from there, go optimize and do what you need to do. So this is the offline migration process. And this lines up with the third module in the actual workshop. So once you've done this migration that we talked about optimizing and managing, and we cover all sorts of aspects to this, but one really neat thing we show you is something called SQL Assessment. This is really cool technology. Ebru from our team and our colleague has worked on this. And the concept is this. Let's take all the best practices we know from the community and from Microsoft, and let's embed this into the portal where you can go scan your virtual machine once you've migrated and take a look at some best practices of things you may do. We cover everything from making sure your VM is configured correctly for storage and so forth, but we also look inside SQL Server. So two of the things I call out in the workshop is to make sure you're using things like lock pages in memory and instant file initialization that can really help your performance. Well, this tool will catch that if you don't have those configured. So, you know, you've done your migration offline, you've restored your database into VM, and now you want to make sure you have the best experience going forward in virtual machine. And so SQL Assessment's a great example. It's in preview right now to help you go do that.
Awesome. Okay, so I've migrated to VM. I understand some of the ways to optimize. What about Manage Instance?
Yeah, so in the SQL 19 scenario, if we give you like a example requirements, and part of this example is that the ISV app is okay with you going to a versionless SQL server, and you want the full benefits of platform as a service. So it kind of looks something like this. Here's your SQL server. Here's your managed instances in this blue box. That's the virtual cluster. What you're going to do is you're going to use the Azure Data Studio extension to do similar to what I showed you in the previous slide, where you're going to use the self-hosted runtime on your on-premises environment, back up your database and put it in a folder. Azure Data Studio with DMS will take that, put it in Azure Blob Storage, and then something will kick in called the log replay service within Managed Instance to restore that database. Now you notice here that the status of the database is yellow. That's because it hasn't been recovered yet, so it's not online. So a typical scenario would be you do the initial full backup and restore, but now you want to do a continuous set of log backups and log restores because this is online, right? Your concept is I got to stay online as long as possible until I'm ready to cut over. So you can go through Azure Data Studio and do all of this through like a wizard-like experience. So let's say that at some point in time, you're ready for this cutover process. You go in Azure Data Studio, you tell it, I'd like to cut over. And then what happens is it will automatically do a final log restore, run recovery, and now you see it's green and managed instance. And so the time window to migrate is very, very tight because you controlled when the app is now going to get redirected to managed instance. Now, you do have one other option that we don't demo, we talk about, and that is you could use transactional replication to do something like this. It's not as efficient as doing here with our ADS scenario. So you could have your managed instance as a subscriber, and you could be publishing transaction changes and eventually cut over, or the log replay service is available to you directly through PowerShell. to do a very similar thing. But I really love the ADS experience because it's nice wizard. It's very directed, very guided, gives you a lot of progress information. And so that's how you would do an online migration to managed instance. Now, just like we talked about the VM, you're going to want to optimize and manage this. So there's a lot of stuff we talk about, but a couple things to consider that you may not know about. Number one, to take advantage of licensing is to use Azure Hybrid Benefit, because you want to take advantage of your SQL Server licenses to only have to pay for the compute and storage of managed instance. You want the SQL license to be paid for with something you've already paid for, right? We also have something called maintenance windows, where you can decide like when would Microsoft apply fixes or patches or update the service in the back end. You can have some customization of when that occurs. You also have security options, things like Azure Active Directory authentication, different ways to secure your managed instance. We go through those. And then you can use things like SQL Insights or use the portal or set up ways to go monitor your service and resource health. So now if you think about the modules we've gone through, we did the offline scenario, right? And then we did the managed instance. We use an online process, and you can do it offline there as well. And we talk about it, but we show you the online process. And then of course, now we would dive in and show you some of the best practices to optimize and manage that managed instance once you've migrated there.
Awesome. This feels really great already. And I think you had mentioned there was one more module that comes after all this.
Yeah. So the thought is this: you're in Azure Virtual Machine already, and maybe you're there for months, maybe a year, I don't know, but you've worked with your ISV app. Remember, you're running SQL 16 here, and the ISV app has said to you, hey, we're ready now to support something like a managed instance. And you as a customer have a desire to go to that. So here's a really cool thing. We show you inside the workshop how to back up your databases to Azure Blob Storage, like using like automated backups. So you are through a process of having existing backups already in Azure Blob Storage. And remember, in our other scenarios, we use something called the self-hosted runtime with a folder on your machine. Because your backups are in Azure now, to go from VM to managed instance, we can still use Azure Data Studio, but we can take advantage of the fact your backups are already in Azure. So now you can do an online migration using Azure Data Studio, just use the existing backups already in the cloud, and go through that same process that we showed you on how to back up logs and restore them and eventually cut over, and now you're back online. So this is more efficient, but it makes sense because you're already in the cloud and you have your backups that already exist in Azure Storage. So we've kind of completed the circle here, right? We've shown you, if you're in VM and you want to make that choice to go to managed instance, there is an online way to do that. And it's more efficient than if you just had to keep your backups over on premises.
Awesome. Yeah, I love it. And we do see customers making this phased approach to migration, where they go to VM right, and then they go to managed instance. So I think it makes total sense to end with this. As we kind of wrap, do you have any tips or tricks for folks that are just getting started?
Absolutely. One of the things, we have a whole team that works on migration, Anna, you probably have hosted them on your show, and I work with them closely as we do these materials. But one of the things I love that we've built is something called the data migration guide or hub. So if you look at AKMS data migration, this is a one-stop shop for everything to go to Azure, whether it's SQL Server or it's third-party databases. If you want to make that move, you go to this site. It's an easy site to remember. You just pick and choose your source, where you want to go, and we have a complete step-by-step guidance. So you can kind of think of the workshop as a practical set of examples on how to apply the best practices that we show you in the data migration guides.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Bob. This has been awesome. I've learned a lot, even just through this sneak peek, and I think our viewers probably have too. To our viewers, be sure to grab some of these URLs. We'll put the links in the description for you to learn more about the data migration guides, the data migration workshop that Bob is building, so you get all the slides, as well as our Migrating to SQL series on Data Exposed. So Bob, once again, thanks so much. Our viewers, leave us a like, leave us a comment, let us know what you think, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.